What a beautiful fucking day in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. The sun was shining today, and there was one song that got into my mind, and I just want to play a little bit for you. It sure was. Nice pick. Welcome back, everybody, to the Sports Ethos Toronto Raptor Podcast. And I'm your host, Mr. El Hoopo. That's H-O-O-P-O. And today it's just Max P and myself, because A-Rod's got some dental spasms. He's on the bench. He's getting some of that dental work done. So good luck to you, A-Rod. We're thinking of you, but we're going to hold it down. Let's go. What's going on, Max P?
Just chilling, fams. Just chilling.
How beautiful was today?
Oh, sun today was amazing. Shining. Oh, yeah, I ain't. Pretty ladies complimenting my outfit. Sun shining.
Man.
I mean, it was just, you know, good vibes all the way around.
It was good vibes the whole day. I went and sat out and baked in the sun. I'm a ginger. I love the sun, man. And then I had my new running shoes coming, right, because my shoes are dead. And I'm like, I don't think they're going to come in time before my run. So I go up, put my old running shoes. Ding dong. Oh, there's my shoes.
Nice.
Boom, put my new ones on. Boom, I have one of my personal best runs. It was just today, man, was just a beautiful, beautiful fucking day. So, salute to the sun. All right. So today, folks, listen up. So right now, the Raptors, what time is it? Yes, it's right now as we're recording this, it's 10 after 9. Raptors are probably just tipping up right now in Phoenix, Arizona. So we will keep you updated as we go. But this right here, we're going to set the table. Last game was the Pelicans were in town here in Toronto. And they smacked, just waxed, cooked the Raptors. 139 to the Raptors 98. That's a 41-point loss for the dinosaurs. Max P, give me one word. Hit me. What's your vibe on that one?
That's the word right there. Just because when it goes bad, like even for I was watching the Lakers game the other day. They took that L, and So I'm watching the beginning of the game, and they're up 19 fast. I'm like, oh, no. Mm-hmm. So as soon as Sacramento started, like, getting back on their feet and went on their little run, you know, like the typical little comeback run, they just kept running the whole game. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And the Lakers would do their little thing, but by then they were already up by 20. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, like, things can flip in the NBA on a dime. Man. But if you're not ready, it won't flip back.
No.
You know?
This you'll be fighting. Flip back.
You'll be fighting and fighting, and you'll just never, like, cats can really hit you with the Mike Tyson punch. Like, you're about to do the Jake Paul, you know?
Oh, man. Okay. Let's just get into that right now.
Let's get into it.
I was going to talk about it later, but I hope that Mike Tyson just knocks that boy the fuck out and sends him home so he, one, quits boxing, two, gets night sweats and reoccurring nightmares from fighting Mike Tyson. And then I hope he just gets, I don't hope he gets a concussion, but I kind of hope he gets a concussion so he gets the memory for the rest of his life. He should have never disrespected boxing this way, because that is the greatest boxer of all time, Mike Tyson. Knock him out. Knock him out, Mike.
I loved how Jake Paul is a troll and somehow the hero of boxing all at the same time. It's amazing.
Duh.
Because you're the second person I've heard say that exact same thing.
Really?
I need this guy to get knocked out. I need these youngins to know what we was looking at back then, like just to get a little peek of what it was like to be in the Tyson era. That was
a true lion, a real lion. Somebody just needs to get in Mike's ear, like right before the fight, and just whisper in his ear and go, "Do it for Gus," and he'll kill him.
He'll kill him. You can say "Do it for Gus." You can say "Do it for Pac." You can say "Do it." Anybody? Or there's a few cats you could just name, and it's on.
is on, because he'll just switch. He'll just switch. Yes. That's game over. Jake Paul, game good over. Luck, buddy. All right. So your one word was. Mine is Zion, because Zion, he impressed me. He looked good. This is the Zion I like to see. He put on a show. He was that larger than life character that just, you know, he just stood out to me, and that's the Zion everybody wants to see. No one has a bad, you know, bone in their body for Zion. Everybody wants to see him succeed. We have since day one, so it was good to see him do it. So Zion helped wax the rap. So and that was that. Did you see anything on the rap side that stuck out to you in this one, other than just getting, you know, just getting smacked? Was there anything that stuck out to you in this one, other than, you know, the bullshit?
I was listening to the Pelicans broadcast, because I like to listen to what other teams say about the Raptors replay. And I noticed that we're pretty high in the league when it comes to assists. Mm. We move the ball around. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I did not know that as bad as we are. We're one of the best teams at moving the ball around and hitting a fast break. So I like what Darko's doing. He just doesn't have the tools. Too much disruption. Mm. Things need to get settled. Right now, we're like a team that doesn't even have a steady roster. And there's going to be games where we just get smacked.
Like this. That one right there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it, And you know what? It's purely on the side now of it is truly letting all just the young guns run, because Pirtle's now out. It looks like he's going to be out for the rest of the season. He had surgery on his pinky finger. So literally the only guys now, you know, you could call, you know, part of the core is RJ, Kelly, and Quik. Mm-hmm. And
tells me if the season wasn't so bad, Pirtle wouldn't need that surgery, you know.
Yeah. Memphis Slim, Grady Dick, he had 2 points. Kansas Slim. He had 2 points and 2 rebounds. Don't give up on him. He's a rookie. Yeah, he's a rookie. I keep my eye on him. I keep my eye on all the young guys. And so it was a rough one for him, but he's gonna bounce back. I have a feeling he's gonna bounce back tonight. So So hey, this is gonna be it for the rest of the year. It's gonna be ups and downs. It's gonna be like you said. You're gonna get smacked one night, and then the next night they're gonna be in it, and then they're gonna lose a heartbreaker. And then there's gonna be another game where they're gonna win by 15. You know what I mean? So it's going to be all over the place. You can't, you know, it's a tough one to coach, to go again to your point on Darko. This is going to be a tough one to coach. Right now, it's let's get a rotation of the young guys to see what they can do, like we've been saying.
He's running his system. Like we're up there in fast break points. We're up there and moving the ball. So he's playing the way that he wants them to play. Mm-hmm. We just suck, you know. Yeah, because to be up there in assists and so down in our record is like, whoa.
Yeah.
Our roster is definitely topsy turvy. I did, like that really crystallized it, right? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, crystallized. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I hear you. Yeah. Well, yeah, I don't have anything else from that one, because that's one of those games. Also, as an athlete, you just say, okay, on to the next one. So I think as a podcast athlete, on to the next one.
On to the next, like LeBron when he walked off with that so-called bad ankle the other night.
Oh, what's that? Let him know,
Max P. You know, a little just the quickness of bullshit. You know what? I'm done with this. Y'all deal with the rest of this. Honestly, too many times.
This guy. All right, cool. So I'm quit. A-Rod's not here again. I see his dental spasms. He's out there. Get through it, A-Rod. Get through it. I've been there. We've all been there. You gotta spend some of that time to get it all right.
If the problem is, he probably waited until he had to go.
So now
you and me both know he's gonna be there for at least a few months. At least. just getting all kind of work done you never knew you needed, you know?
I remember when I had that, it was about 6 months. It was like back and forth,
back and forth. Another cavity, wisdom teeth, a re-root canal. I had a cracked tooth. I had a re-root canal.
It's like redid my whole mouth. Well, speaking of that, that's a good question. So if you had, so I've just seen, you know, there was this, I did take the subway the other day. I try to avoid it like the plague. I put in my time. I put in, you know, 15 years on the subway. I feel like I did a bid on the subway. You know what I mean? So I've been on that train. Don't worry about it. But I was on the train the other day, and this guy, he was eating an ice cream cone, and he opened his mouth, and his mouth was just his teeth. Speaking of teeth, his teeth were just like rotten, and they were just like yellow and just rotten looking, right? Like it looked like he broke his tooth on the ice cream. Like if you were to hand that man a banana, he'd probably bust his teeth open, right? So it looked like what are those the construction guys put down to hold a spot? What do you call those things? Anyways, it does. The thing on the street, so you can hold a parking spot. What do you call that thing? A pylon. These rotten pylons hanging out of his mouth. Anyways, I was thinking, I was like, is there anywhere in the city that this man could get some help? That I could have assisted him with to maybe like help his mouth and help him get healthy. Do you know of anywhere that in the city that could, you know, help this man out? Help banana mouth?
I know a place. They're the kings of protein powder. And
what's that?
It's Popeye Supplements.
Popeye Supplements. for all your rotten mouth having motherfuckers, go to Popeye Supplements.
And get all that right.
And all right. So, as you know, that means this is another edition of this or
that.
Yes, sir. And this one is going to be, we're going to stay in Toronto, but we're going to stay in New Orleans again. Shout out to Young Bleed.
What up, Young Bleed?
Yes, yes. All right. So the first one I got here is, if you had a draft, I like this one. We've done this two episodes in a row. That if you were the GM of your squad, you know, who would you draft here with these two options? Would you draft Zion Williamson? Did I say Williamson? Zion Williamson. Why am I getting his name mixed up? Anyways, Zion or AD? If you're going to start your team off, who are you taking? Zion or AD? Two legends, New Orleans legends, but who would you take with your pick?
Very mysterious players, just like New Orleans. Ain't that something?
Right, exactly.
Both of these guys are like hard to figure out. You know what I mean? And New Orleans is one of those cities that this is like, you know, it's got all kind of, all kind of mysteries and mystical type stuff and real stories, fake stories, a mix of both. You know what I mean? Like,
true.
I think I would go with I think I'm going with AD.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm going with AD.
Why? Because
even though he had all those injury problems, like he got hurt on schedule. You know what I'm saying? Like
he did.
Yeah.
He would never leave a game without going in the locker room. Still doesn't.
On schedule, like you can set your watch to this dude getting hurt or acting like he's hurt. You know what I'm saying? Like he was a drama queen and Mr. Glass all wrapped up in one.
Yeah.
And he had that all the way up until this season. Like, this is the only season we can say he hasn't been acting
like a bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's true.
But when he did play, he did show that he was one of the best players in the league.
Yeah.
And that's not easy to do with playing so little, you know?
Yeah.
And this year he's shown that, hey, I can play all the way. And it's not my fault, you know?
I'm happy for him this year, to be honest. I'm happy to see
I'm happy for him, too, because he was getting all the blame. And he deserved some of it, but he was getting too much. It was turning into a Westbrook situation. Like, you know, you were turning into the scapegoat. So it was like, I'm glad that he's shaking that off. Nobody can say it's AD's fault this year.
No. All right. Mm-hmm. So you got AD drafting AD.
Yes, that's sir. A good pick. AD.
For me, I'm with you with him on that matters. I think they've laid a bit too much blame on him in New Orleans, but at the same time, super talented, unbelievably talented AD is, and mm-hmm. it's a shame with all the injuries. It's a shame, you know, that ended up being placed on him, you know, a label that was placed on him that, you know, he's just made of glass, he's mm-hmm. he can't make it through a whole game, and yada mm-hmm. yada yada, which is a lot of it's true, but yep. you know, and now that he gets that one season, it's not like that just gets disappeared off of the history books. That's the fact.
It's
right?
it's part of your story.
It is your career. Mm-hmm. And then you go to Zion, and you know, a lot the same. It's with his health, it's with the injuries,
the injuries,
the weight,
the off the
you
court
said it last episode. His discipline, his disciplines. But my pick is this: is I'm going with Zion, and the reason I'm going with Zion is it's not like I would have this information before drafting. It's not like the New Orleans situation would have already been done, but I would make sure that I would have the best doctors, mm-hmm. the best sports psychologists before any, you know, drafts go down anyways. Like the Masai is the best doctors. He has one of the best organizations in the league.
And
like
Masai is a stand-up guy.
And he's a stand-up guy.
He knows when somebody, hey, don't look down, look around. He knows when to smack somebody up.
Yes.
You know? And yes. When somebody's getting off track and what that's going to lead to, he can see that.
That's what
squares,
he needs.
Squares can't see that. And Zion did not have anybody near that.
Doesn't have
in New Orleans. Nobody gave him any kind of heads up.
And I think if he had that surrounding mm-hmm. him, not just the GM, full blown, if he had that, God, this guy would be.
So you're willing to roll the dice and say, I feel you.
I'm going to put the tools around him. I'm going to put the right foundation around him, the plumbing. Everything's going to be straight. You're going to come in. It's going to be, and let's see, let's roll. And then if still it's a failure, then it's like, well, then it is definitely something else. And it's,
but you can't even get mad because the potential with Zion is through the roof. It's a gamble worth taking. I understand, but I like AD.
Yeah. All right. That's a good tie. Mm-hmm. All right. On this one, who do you got as the bigger dog? Who's the bigger dog in this situation? We got Lance Stephenson. Lance. Whisper Lance.
Legendary moment.
Legendary. Fuck you, LeBron. I was such a Lance Stephenson fan after that. I was like, man, I love this dude. So we got Lance Stephenson or PJ Tucker. He's dog. PJ Tucker or Lance Stephenson. Who you got as the bigger dog? And you remember that situation in Toronto where Lance did that layup at the very end when they were up like 10-12, and he shouldn't have did that. And then PJ went at him. Looked like he was going to kill him. But who do you got? Lance or
Lance to make him dance.
PJ. Yes,
and Lance. PJ Tucker. Probably the best sneaker collection.
PJ, yeah.
Definitely out of celebrities. Definitely out of the celebrity world.
I think
PJ's got to have the best sneaker collection.
Yep.
Man, these are two legends right here.
I know. This is tough. I know.
Do you know where PJ is from?
I don't. I mean, I could look it up real quick.
Because I know Lance is from Brooklyn.
Is Lance from Brooklyn?
Yeah, he's from Brooklyn.
Of course he's from Brooklyn.
Old Brooklyn.
PJ Tucker. Oh, yeah, exactly. Raleigh, North Carolina.
I knew he was from North Carolina. He got North Carolina like written all over.
Yeah, he kind of does.
I'm going with PJ Tucker.
You're going with PJ?
Yeah. North Carolina is, they build stand-up cats.
Yeah.
You ever heard of that? You ever heard of the Frank Matthews story?
Not fully. Explain it to me real quick.
Biggest heroin dealer in America. Had the same connection as the mob, but he was one guy.
God damn.
So when the mob goes to the French Connection to re-up for this family or that family, he was going to re-up for himself. Same connect. Frank Matthews disappeared though. Only
of course, a guy like that disappears.
Yeah, he disappeared, but nobody knows whether he got killed. Man. But the story is that he just left with his girl, you know?
That's when you're a legendary, super legendary gangster, is when the story ends where he just lived on disappeared.
Lived on the same street as the boss just before John Gotti. The boss that John Gotti shot outside the steakhouse?
Yeah.
He lived on the same street as that guy.
Wow.
Having parties and everything. It was crazy.
I love it.
So North Carolina, Michael Jordan, Frank Matthews, PJ Tucker. North Carolina got legends.
Yeah, so you're going
I got to respect North Carolina.
All right, PJ Tucker. I like that pick. When PJ was here in Toronto, absolutely loved him. I wanted him to stay. I really wanted him to get paid. I wanted him to stay. I kind of wish he still did, because that was that dog that we needed. And when he was on the court with us, it just felt right. It was a tough team. Sandpaper. Mm-hmm. I love dudes like
Very
that.
Very important time for the Raptors when he came to the team.
Oh, it was huge. With Lance, I love Lance. I love his attitude. I love what he did. I love when he blew and whispered at
everybody.
Did that
to Lace.
LeBron, man. Oh man, I love that. But I'm also gonna go with PJ. I'm going with PJ Tucker. Just because I just love what he. I think because we got a closer look when he was here at what he brought to the team, and you could just feel it. You could feel it that the opposing team just respected you more when PJ was there, and especially then too. This was a few years back, and he could still contribute. He
built his whole rep that he went from Houston, Clippers, all over the place, Milwaukee, off of the rep he built in Toronto when we brought him back from overseas.
Yes,
you know what I mean. Like we've seen him craft a career with the way he played on the Raptors. You know, like he made a career out of that. You know,
he did. Yeah. Well, shout out to both those guys, PJ and Lance. Lance will make him dance.
Lance will make him dance.
Yeah, all right, so we got a fight now. So we got a street fight. So we got Kendrick Perkins in this.
Okay,
corner.
Kendrick.
Big Kendrick. I love that name, Kendrick Perk. So we got Kendrick Perkins in this corner, and we got, rest in peace, an absolute legend from Michigan, Mr. Robert Tractor Trailer right here.
Aha, Robert Tractor Trailer.
What a monster. What a monster he was.
Man, he passed away? How did he pass away?
Yeah, man. I can't remember exactly. I don't want to misquote it. I'm not 100% sure. I do believe it was... If my memory serves me correct, it may have been something to do with his heart.
Okay, so it was like some kind of medical thing.
It was, I'm pretty sure it was a pure medical thing. But what a legend, Robert Tractor Trailer, man.
Yeah.
So who do you got, Perk or Trailer in a street
fight? I'm going with Tractor Trailer,
man.
I'm a Michigan fan, but when Tractor Trailer was there, Michigan was still kind of hanging on to. Still that big school status, you know, and they were still really popular. Tractor Trailer came in there a little disappointed with his career at Michigan and more disappointed in the NBA, but he was still like a lovable guy. Like, you know, it was easy to root for kind of guy, you know, and he seemed like, you know, he seemed like he had some street in him. He seemed like he'd been through some things, you know?
Yeah.
I never believed Kendrick's tough guy thing. It never...
Yeah, it
never convinced me.
No, he
I'm
never
saying
convinced
he
me
saw,
either. Yeah,
but
yeah.
It just it didn't scare me, you know.
It's so funny with Perkins, right? So when I was, you know, I've been with my beard and everything like that. I remember I was growing out my mustache right here, and trying to get my line up a bit higher up here, right? And I'm like, because I just wanted it to join up like this, right? I remember bringing a picture, and I was like, I didn't even Kendrick had a nice beard going on at this one point where it joined up high, right? So I brought a picture of it to my barber, and it was funny. He looked at me, and he's like, you do know that is enhancements. I go, what's enhancements?
What?
He goes, it's spray. They spray the line so that it conjoins that high. I'm like, I go, that's
Are
not
you
even
kidding
real.
Me?
He goes, yeah, that's not even real, man. So I don't know. I don't know. I don't want to put his beard on blast because your beard is nice. And coming from another beard gentleman to you, Kendrick. But if that's true, stop spraying on your beard, man. You don't need to be doing that.
Wow. Spray on beard.
For your line to be high. Yep. Yeah.
I was watching a Wesley Snipes movie the other day.
Man.
And he was wearing like a disguise, like he was playing different characters in the movie.
Yeah.
and they had his hair. Mm-hmm. It was obviously a wig, but I was like, damn, that hair looks really real. You know what I'm saying? They're like, that looks like black folks' hair right there, but that's obviously not Wesley Snipes' hair right there.
Yeah, you know?
So, yeah, bro, like, they can spray with some, they can really fake that stuff, bro.
Yeah, so I'm like, enhancements. So I was like, nah, never mind. Enhancements to spray. I'm like, nah, they don't even make ginger. Imagine, that's how good. Anyways, I didn't even know about this. Shout out to
your Bob. About that, bro.
Yeah, guys are doing that, man. The lineups right here, they'll spray the. Anyways, it's crazy.
Bro, I just heard one of my favorite sports podcasts talking about the locker room at the gym.
Hmm.
And how the young guys be in the mirror just posing like ladies and stuff. And it's
that angers me right now.
Yeah. So, bro, cats will spray on a beard. Yeah, cats are petty out here now.
Yeah, and that kind of changed my attitude about Perkins, too, because I was like, oh, if you're really spraying, your beard.
I'm hearing about dudes with fake abs. I'm hearing about all kinds of lipo
and
all dudes doing all kinds of suspect stuff. So the spray beard thing, the spray beard thing might be real, bro. It might be real.
And you know who would bust all these guys' face open? Robert Tractor Trailer, man.
Yes, he would.
So you know what, Kendrick, you're done. 1, 2, 3, boom. Yeah, you're like Tyson on Jake Paul, man. I'm going all 100% with Tractor Trailer, man. Rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
All right, so now we're into the shouts out. So we got shout outs. I was going through the all-time roster. Shout out to Bonzi Wells, man. I used to love Bonzi Wells. I thought he was nice in Portland. He was just a nice piece. He's a nice little basketball.
He was a really good player.
Remember him? Yeah.
Oh, he was a great player. Great player. In today's modern day NBA with all the social media and sportscasters that go after you, he wouldn't have survived. But in that era, Bonzi Wells was great.
Bonzi Wells, yes. Shout out to Bonzi Wells. Another one who played for the Raptors and the New Orleans Pelicans is Grievous Vasquez. Now, I became a Grievous Vasquez fan when he was here when we had that playoff run for the first time in a long time, and Masai made the trade for all the boys from Sacramento, and he was in on that trade with Chuck Hayes.
He came in
with John Solomons, and they came in and had that playoff run. And when he was standing there when they were doing the anthem, and he got choked up because it was so intense. It was so emotional. He started crying when they were singing "Oh Canada." I'm like, this guy, he really does wear his heart on his sleeve. And I love dudes who, you know, they just, you know, just love it for what it is, and they're not trying to hide it. And Grievous Vasquez had that, and I love that about him, man. And he brought some of that nice attitude to the team, and I liked it. I wish he would have stuck around, but that was short lived.
Yeah, shout out to all the Latin players. They got that heart.
Yes, you know what I'm saying?
Like Alvarado from New Orleans, one of those cats.
Yeah, I like him.
Like, he's in the NBA strictly off of heart. Like, strictly. That dude, you know, like, shout out to all the Latin cats out there. You guys have skills the rest of us don't got, man.
There's just something there, right? It's just so much heart. Alvarado, that's so true. I love that kid. Tyson Chandler. Shout out to Tyson Chandler. I wanted to ask A-Rod because he seems to know all the facts about all these dudes. But I wanted to know if that picture of him back in the day where he was in some coffee shop, and it was skinny legs picture. And you remember that picture? And it was like, it didn't look real. I was like, I wanted to ask A-Rod, is that real? Was that a real picture, or was that Photoshop back in the day? But anyways, shout out to Tyson Chandler, because I was a Tyson Chandler fan. Chicago, you know, I thought he was going to do more in his career.
Yeah, but same, I really, because you know, he came in with a bang. Like, you thought he was going to beat
something.
The Baby Bulls, that's what they used to call those guys.
Yep, him. Who else?
Eddie Curry,
Ron Artest, I think, even was there.
I think Ron Artest was in the mix, yep.
Yeah, it was a good team, man. Mm-hmm. Derrick Rose, maybe?
I think it might have been Jay Will area. Will era.
Yes.
And then he got hurt. But yeah, like Baby Bulls.
Yes. Yeah, so shout out Tyson Chandler. Another one, we got Lamon Murray. I don't know why this came up, but I was looking at the old Raptors, and Lamon Murray, man. Remember when Lamon was here?
Yes. I remember because they used to show the reruns on NBA TV, those old Raptor rerun games.
Yes. Yes. And he had the face mask on, remember?
They would show the Raptors in Vancouver playing those weird stadiums. Yeah, shout out to Lamon Murray.
Lamon Murray, man. He could have hit a shot. So on that note, that was another edition of This or
That,
brought to you by Popeye Supplements. All right, that was good. So let's go around the NBA real quick and see what's been going on. I got a couple of notes here. But man, I called it last episode. I want to see Minnesota Timberwolves. I was all over Minnesota. So happy I got them to win it all. And then, boom, the news comes out today. Cat down.
Meniscus I've seen Cat down, and I was like, wow. They're out. Come on, you know? Man. Ain't that something? Philadelphia, gone. Minnesota, gone. Just like that.
Just like that.
Just like that.
I did read today. Shams came out and said, "Oh yeah, he's out indefinitely." But then news about an hour later comes saying, "Well, no, hold on. Mm-hmm. We don't know yet how many weeks he could miss. So there is the possibility that he could be back by playoff time. We'll see." So I don't know.
You can't just come off the you can't come out of the rehab room full speed. So it's
I know. I thought this was going to be the year for him, too, because he goes back and forth.
It was, because I was like, a couple of years ago, I was like, trade this dude. Let Ant-Man breathe. This dude's holding him back. Yep. But he seemed to get the message. And now look.
This year, it seemed that everybody got the message. Gobert, him. Yep.
Gobert definitely got his shit together this year. Impressive.
He's one of the best top 50 players this year. It's unreal.
I'm very impressed with Gobert because I kind of threw him away too. Like, man, you're zapped, bro.
That's why I said. That's why I had them to be the dark horse Cinderella team out of the West and possibly win it all. But bam, Cat down. So Cat, heal up, man. We're rooting for you. Another one. Last night, scary incident on the bench at the Oklahoma City Thunder game. Bismack Biyombo, former Raptor,
Seen a little bit of that.
On the bench.
He just collapsed on the bench. So was he sitting down? Like, what happened?
He was just sitting down and he just collapsed.
Wow. And,
it reminded me of something that happened to me this summer. As I don't know a lot of you know, but I'm a competitive runner. I do races and, I take it very, very seriously. And I had an incident happen to me last summer where I came back from a run, came inside, I was getting my water, and then I literally collapsed.
You just collapsed too?
Pretty much. I could feel it coming and then it just to collapse. And a good thing my wife was there and everything. It just terrified me. And I changed up some things after that with my eating and changed up some things with my intake of certain supplements I was taking. It terrified me. And so I went to the doctor, blah, blah, blah. Heart's good and everything like that. But things like that can happen. And they did check him out, I guess, after biz, that is. And health or medical-wise, I guess he's okay. So, good thoughts and prayers are to Bismack for that, but it's scary.
Man,
scary stuff,
bro. I mean, scariest thing I've ever been through is the sweats after a really strong blunt or mixing the liquor and
I've been there.
Too many rum and cokes at the club, you get the sweats festive. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man.
Now that's happened to me, multiple times at the studio. Cats be laughing at me.
Man,
But man, passing out though, scary, that should have scared the shit out of me.
I felt it coming, and I said, uh-oh, and then douche. And then I started, I crawled to the, it was scary, man. But anyways, Biz, I hope you're all right, man, because Toronto still loves you. Yeah.
So he wasn't, like, completely knocked out, right? He just sort of.
I don't know. All I know is he just collapsed. And, so hopefully he's okay. I wanted to get your take. I know we jumped on it, but Mike Tyson and Jake Paul. Where's your mindset on this Mike Tyson Jake Paul fight in July? What do you want to see happen, Max P?
I want to see Mike Tyson fight for real. I do not want to see him keep the guy around just trying to make money. I don't want to see that. I want to see a real fight. Not.
Yeah, good point. I really hope
I want to see a real fight. I don't think Tyson's going to do the whole he's signing up for the event. That's as much business as Tyson's going to do. Once he's in the ring, I don't think he's going to be businessman. You know, I think he's going to be a boxer. So hopefully we get a nice flashback.
I hope so.
Like all these LeBron fans, they see LeBron do a dunk and they get memories of when he was in Miami and stuff. You know what I mean? Like, we could be like that with Tyson and just sort of.
Even if he comes to the ring, wearing that black towel, with the cutout,
with just
that sound.
See him, And if I can see him do one step back with an uppercut,
do it for
that's all I need. That's all I need.
I'm a fight connoisseur.
Yeah, a good after fight interview. I need that too.
Yes, I hope so.
Where's that old man that used to piss off those boxers? Like, we need somebody to really do a good interview after this fight, man.
I hope so. I just hope, I didn't even know this fight was happening, man.
We need to give the kids the whole shebang of what an old fight used to be.
Oh,
the spectacle. The walk-in, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
All of that stuff.
The walk-in was so huge. Remember that?
And huge.
Oh, my gosh. Vegas and the bright lights. And then Tyson's just sweating itchy balls because he's been fucking everybody before the fight.
And he's just serious. He's not smiling. He's not looking around. It's like he's walking into an empty room. It's just me and you.
Just a killer. Oh, man. Love Mike Tyson, man. Above and beyond all the other boxers, that's my guy. All right, cool. So next up then, we have Portland. Raptors are in Portland Saturday night at 10 p.m. So it's March 9th, 10 p.m. You know, what do you want to see in that one? I know Scoot is back. He's been out for a while. And Scoot, I guess, will possibly be back Saturday against the Raps. So what would you like to see in this one?
This is Battle of the Scrubs.
Yeah, it really is.
So I'd like to see how we measure up against other teams that are just, you know, flopping around in the mud trying to get off their back. So it'd be nice. It's like a measuring stick, but in another kind of way, you know?
Yeah.
How bad are we, right?
Yeah. I want to see Scoot. I'm a believer in Scoot. I think give him a couple more years. He's going to be one of the best point guards in the league.
I root for Scoot, yes.
Yeah, I root for Scoot. I think Chauncey, you know, keep giving him a chance. I don't want to see Portland just give up on him as a coach. A lot of guys shit on Chauncey as a coach. But I think keep giving him a chance. I've always been a Chauncey fan as well. So hopefully he can
keep his job and turn that bad boy around.
Yeah, get it together out there and get rid of what's his name, DeAndre Ayton. Get him out of there, man. Send him.
Ooh, I forgot he's on that team. Yeah, they're not going anywhere with a guy like that on the roster. Chauncey Billups is the one who told us stories about Carmelo Anthony. And noticing that certain nights when he got his points and they lost, he was all right with it. You know, he told those stories, so he knows that guy doesn't belong on his roster.
Played with a guy like that in high school. His stat line would be just all over the place. Beautiful stat line, right? But we'd lose by like 10 or 15, and he wouldn't care. He'd be smiling, joking around, like, oh, okay, I had 20 points, 12 rebounds, 6 assists, 3 steals, a couple of blocks, you know, just crazy. I hated playing with guys like that, man. It's driving me nuts. No heart. Mm-hmm. All right. On that note, I want to end this. First of all, I want to give. I got a neighborhood Steve who's in the neighborhood here who listens to the podcast. But his father also listens to the podcast. His name is Dan Baffa. Dan Baffa, if you're listening right now, big shout out. I guess he's a big fan of the podcast. Loves his Raptors.
Big shout out.
Yes. So shout out from El Hoopo and. Max P, let him know. Big shout out for Max P. So, Dan Baffa.
What up, Dan Baffa?
That's a great name, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I know it is a gangster name. Dan Baffa. Dan Baffa Construction. Well, it's actually not a construction company.
Not a construction company.
Yeah, it's laying bodies out there. Dan Baffa over here. Fucking guy. All right, on that note, Max P, good seeing you, my man, and we'll be seeing. Hopefully, we'll have A-Rod back on Sunday.
Yeah.
This was another episode of the Sports Ethos Toronto Raptor Podcast, and I'm your host, Mr. El Hoopo, H-O-O-P-O, and that's Max P. You better pay me, and A-Rod, get better, man. Come on back on Sunday. Have a beautiful, just white smile, ready to go to let the world know that the Big Three is back. Hit like, hit subscribe. You heard me.